Shalom, family trendsetter. Hopefully you had a wonderful weekend. I sure did. And the reason why my weekend was wonderful, because the Most High spoke to me, had a lot of insight, gave me a lot of revelation. And one of the revelation that he gave me is this. How is it that we are praying to him daily, in some cases on our knees, with our hand closed, where you're supposed to have your hands stretched forth to receive the blessing? But how is it that we are, as so-called Christian, not me, because I would never profess myself to be a Christian. Christianity is a white man religion given to the slave, you know, when they first came to the shores of the America and, you know, around the world. But anyway, how is it that you guys are praying on your knees, asking God for blessing, right? But in turn, you go to church on a Sunday, the first day of the week, when in the Bible it tells you or instruct us to go to church, or to have a set apart day, which is a Sabbath day, on the seventh day of the week, right? Now, some people use the lunar Sabbath, some people use, you know, sun up to sundown, some people use sundown Friday to, sundown Saturday. However you know, practice your Shabbat, it's up to you. But the question again is this. You guys are praying on your knees, but then you feel the need to go to church to get the answer from a pastor. So the question is this, Christian, what makes the pastor so special that you have to go to him after praying on your knees to your God, whoever your God may be? Because a lot of y'all believe that y'all praying to, the Almighty, the creator of the universe, or the Most High, but a lot of y'all are praying to the God of this world, which is Satan. Because my thing is this, if you believe that you're a Christian and your religion is going to save you or give you salvation, and you're praying to your God, shouldn't your God answer your prayer directly? Why do you have to go to church, right? Every Sunday, in some cases Saturday, to receive the answer. And let's say you are receiving the answer from your God, then why are you continuing to go to church religiously, giving your money, tithes and offering, paying for the message from God, instead of realizing that you can have a one-on-one relationship with the Most High God by following the law, statutes and commandments, the Leviticus law, right? Dietary law, which is to eat certain food and not to eat certain food. So again, that's a question that I have, that I had a revelation from the Most High to ask y'all. Because a lot of y'all are praying. The Bible says, in vain do they worship me, right? Paraphrasing through Doctrine of Men. So because a Christian pastor came to you, incidentally, this Christian pastor had to go to a school, right? A theologian school or a Bible seminary school to learn God. I mean, really think about what I'm saying, family. So you have to go to a school in order to be taught to have a relationship with God. And then you have to now, after being taught, right, you have to sell this information to your congregation on Sunday. Now, I'm not going to be on this video too long. I just want to just point out some obvious inconsistency that we have in our lives. Then you have Christians, right, telling you that Jesus Christ died on a cross, but in the Bible he said he was hung on a tree. Now I know a lot of y'all are going to say, well, the tree or the cross was made out of the tree. No, it says hung on a tree. Curses is a man that hangeth on a tree, right? That was mentioned also in the Old Testament. So if your Savior was hung on a tree according to Acts 5:30, then he was cursed. So then why are you worshiping a deity that was cursed because he was hung on a tree? Then Jesus, your Savior, your God, tells you in order to have salvation, first of all, you have to deny yourself, which is cool. Okay, you deny yourself and follow the Most High. But then you also have to deny or hate your relatives, paraphrasing once again, right? And you have to serve him. So in other words, you have to, you know, turn against your mother-in-law, turn against your family, deny them, hate them in order to serve and follow him. That sounds like Satan to me. You know what I'm saying? Because in the Old Testament, the Most High said when the Messiah, King David, will reign, there will be peace on earth. You're not going to be hating anybody. Even in the New Testament, it says, yo, Christ, Jesus said he did not come to bring peace, but to bring a sword. So I don't know, man. So I was reflecting over the weekend, and when I really thought about this religion called Christianity, and I did some research, how many millions, if not billions, of lives that was lost are taken under the guise of this religion. Don't get me wrong, Islam took some lives too, because that's another form of religion. But I'm talking about Christianity, because most of our people are into Christianity. And they believe by following Jesus Christ, including my brother. I have a twin brother. He's a pastor. I told y'all before, he's incarcerated. And me and him be having a lot of debates, you know what I'm saying, on our beliefs. And, you know, one of the things that I do appreciate, you know, after a year or so, now he's referring to the Savior as Yeshua, right? He believes now finally that we are the chosen people of the Bible. He doesn't go to church no more. As a matter of fact, he's a pastor, so he changed his worship service from Sunday to now Saturday, the Shabbat, which is cool. You know, so I think I'm making some strive way. But he still believes that Jesus is God. We had this debate over the week, not over the weekend, but on Friday, that he's a Godhead, the three in one. And, you know, I posed a question to him. Didn't God forbade us to commit adultery? Then if that's the case, then how is it that he himself went and had to commit adultery? Because he believed Jesus is God, right? So he believed also the Holy Spirit is God. So I asked him, how is it that God forbade us to commit adultery with another man's wife? Because Mary was exposed to Joseph, which means that was his wife to be. So how is it not now that the Holy Spirit went and committed adultery by getting her impregnated? Or impregnate her. I'm trying to, you know, tell you the story, and I know it's not coming out clearly, but you know what I'm saying. So Mary got knocked up by the Holy Spirit while she was engaged to Joseph. Okay, it doesn't make sense. So when I posed that question to him, of course he tried to give me his theological breakdown, which, you know, oftentimes when he started to do it, I just cut him off, because that's what Christians like to do. They like to give you the spiritual aspect of things, not the common sense aspect of it, but the spiritual aspect of it. So anyway, again, family, I just wanted to come on here just to share with y'all that if you are praying to God every, you know, day on your knee, then you're supposed to wait and receive him. And the only way you're going to receive what he has to say, you have to, first of all, start following the law, statutes, and commandments, right? Cleansing yourself, making yourself pure. Stop eating certain animal products like pork, crab, shrimp, and lobster. Once you stop doing that, then you can have a one-on-one relationship. You won't have any need now to go to these house of worship, right? These pagan house of worship called churches, in order for your pastor to give you the message. And a lot of times, y'all praying for something, but y'all still not getting the message, because y'all been going to church over 50 years and still haven't gotten the answer that y'all looking for. Yeah, every so often the pastor might, you know, come across or touch on a topic, and you might be like, yes, that was for me. No, that was for everybody. All right, because these are motivational speakers. They're trained. These are like psychologists. They go into your head. They know everybody that come to church got some issues. So they touch on every single issue in everybody's daily life that they can say, that you can say, yeah, that was for me. No, that was for you, him, and her. Okay, so anyway, family, I just wanted to come on here just to share this thought with y'all. Stop praying on your knees, right? If the only way you can get the message is through your pastor on Sunday. Now, if you believe that the Most High will have a one-on-one relationship with you, then you don't need to go to church every Sunday paying your tithes and offering to get whatever message that you believe that the Most High or God is giving your pastor to give to you. You can get this message directly, because I don't go to church. The last time I went to church was maybe 2 weeks ago when I went to a funeral, and it was very, very reluctantly, very, very reluctantly me going into that house of worship, because I believe that's a pagan house of worship. But I just went because, you know, it's tradition. You know, everybody was looking for me to come because it was a close family member. But again, family, really and truly think about some of this stuff that we're engaging in. Christianity was given to our ancestors when they came to the shores. We knew nothing about Christianity. Shit, we didn't even know how to speak English. So how is it now all of a sudden that was a religion? A lot of people like to say, well, the Ethiopian had the first church. Okay, so what? Who gave him the first church? You know what I mean? Remember King Solomon, because a lot of Ethiopians believe that they're Jews because King Solomon and Sheba was involved. And we already know that that's the Ethiopian descendant of, you know, Queen of Sheba and King Solomon. But you got to also remember that King Solomon went into idolatry as well. This is why he was cut off from the Most High. So any way you try to twist it, and justify this religion called Christianity, believe me, I can dispute it. You know what I'm saying? Because I already know that when Moses and all these prophets were alive, they didn't depend on a savior. They got, you know, the message directly from the Most High, gave it to the people. The people did what they had to do. The sacrificial lamb and the sacrifice they was making, the Most High didn't really like it because, you know, he felt like, why do you have to, in other words, prevent is better than cure. Why are you giving me these sacrifices? Why not just do what I tell you to do? Follow the Lord's Tithes and commandments. You know what I'm saying? It's just like almost like what's going on in the land of our enemy, in our captivity. A lot of y'all are following our holy days like Passover and the land of your captivity. I believe in the Bible it says you're supposed to have an unblemished lamb sacrifice. So whatever you're sacrificing to the Most High, it has to be unblemished, right? And a lot of these food that y'all are, you know, partaking in, like these holy days, right? Like, for example, the Passover. You see people on YouTube going to the slaughterhouse, slaughtering a lamb, and you know the grandstanding, broadcasting it. ISUPK. One time I seen a video, it was so hilarious. You know, they there cutting the lamb's throat and, you know, slaughtering the lamb in the land of your enemy and shit. How do you know that this lamb didn't have hormones or all kind of bacteria, all kind of, you know what I'm saying? I mean, just think about some of the stuff that we do. It's so comical. But I just wanted to come on here, family, let y'all know, as so-called black people, we do not need to go to church. You don't have to go to a gathering, right, and pay tithes and offering, even as a Hebrew, because you're not, the tithes and offering that used to be paid, or the tithes that used to be given, was to the Leviticus priest. Last time I checked, we don't have no Leviticus priest in the land of our enemy. Okay, so you don't have to go to these gathering church, Christ Church. Like I used to be a member of them. I stopped going there because I realized they're more Christian. And don't get me wrong, I did take away a lot from them. You know what I'm saying? I did take away a lot from them because they were the first one actually converted me to my nationality, you know, took me away from this pagan religion called Christianity. But however I do see some similarity in Christianity. They still do you know, the what is it, where you drink of the blood and eat of the body, communion. They still do communion, which is Christian pagan, right? They still do baptism, which I believe is still Christian pagan, because again, baptism came from the Nile River. The ancient Egyptian believed that the only time a baby was purified when they was dipped in the Nile River. That's where you get your baptism from. Y'all need to do y'all research, man, because a lot of y'all are just caught up into some shit that y'all really don't know anything about. But I promised one of my subscribers that I was going to stop cursing, you know, try to get my message across without using vulgarity. And I'm trying to do my best, family. Sometimes I just express myself with this cuss word because it releases this tension. All right. But with that, family, I say shalom. Love y'all. And welcome to some of my new subscribers. I want to say peace and blessing. Shalom.